you ever got into the gym and thought, why am I absolutely battered? Motivation's down, energy's a little bit low, and your performance is a little bit down, then watch this video, because it's probably gonna solve that for you in maybe about 10 minutes. So one of the reasons you might be feeling this way is because you need a deload, and that's what this video is all about. Talking through the reasons for why you might need a deload, how to do a deload, and yeah, that's about it. So first of all, let's start with the why. So let's say you've done, you know, a block of training, 8 weeks, 10 weeks, 12 weeks. It's gonna be different for everyone. And maybe you've increased your volume a little bit, your training intensity is super high, and everything else is good, right? Your sleep's good, your nutrition's good, everything is good, but you're starting to feel like you're going a bit downhill, and you want to catch this early. But essentially, with that buildup of fatigue across however many weeks it will be, by the end of it, you need to take some time to reduce volume, reduce down training intensity, and spend maybe half a week to up to 2 weeks, if you're like really in a hole, doing a deload so that you can refresh and then go again afterwards. So the first thing you need to work out is whether you actually need a deload or not. And there's probably 2 points that you want to ask yourself. Number one, is everything else good? Is everything else on point? Like, are you trying to make your sleep good? Have you got a good sleep routine, good sleep hygiene? Number two, how good is your nutrition? Have you been consistent? Have you been hitting your caloric target? Have you been hitting your protein target? And then number three is, where is your training volume? Or have you been pushing stuff like just way too far that you could simply just take that off and you wouldn't need a full-on deload? So, you know, it's quite easy to start in your sessions adding in intensifiers or too many intensifiers, adding in too many sets and just wasting a load of fatigue. Ask yourself those three questions, and if any of them can be improved, improve those first before you go into a deload. So let's say for this example, all of those three things are good. You need to now ask yourself, how is everything else, to decide whether you need a deload or not. And people's deloads, or people will display signs of needing a deload slightly differently to others. So for me, a lot of the time it comes through motivation to train and energy in the gym. That drops, and when that drops, I know that I need a deload. But for other people, it might be sleep quality's got significantly worse, maybe appetite has changed quite significantly for no other apparent reason. And I'd say they're probably the main three: sleep, appetite, and training, motivation / energy. You've got to work out which one comes first for you, and there's unfortunately only one way to work that out, which is actually to just wait until you feel like ass, and then you can kind of see which one has come first. But like I say, for me, it's energy in the gym and motivation in the gym. So like last session, the session before, I was coming in, I was feeling absolutely battered, feeling super tired, and I noticed a little illness coming along as well. Nothing like major, but just a little bit of a cold coming along, which can also come from like that heightened amount of training that you've been doing with the intensity and the volume. It can definitely come from that. So ask yourself those three. Are you any of them? And then you might need a deload. I'll tell you how to do a deload in a second. So how to execute a deload? There's two main ways that I like to do it, with some variation within each one. But essentially, you can either do a deload or you can do a devolume. A devolume is where you take your normal session and reduce the total amount of sets. So let's say, for example, you normally do 3 sets on a seated leg curl. Take it down to 2 or 1, depending on how fatigued you are and how quickly you want to get the deload done. The second option is a deload, which is where you reduce the intensity of your sessions. So you still do the same amount of the same amount of sets, but rather than training to failure, you might train like 5 reps in reserve. So take whatever you did last week and take 5 reps off. Now, I guess a third option is also to just completely take time off the gym. So you might go like 3 days completely off, then 3 days into D volume, or 3 days off, 3 days into a D load. Now, the way that I like to do it, again, depending on how smashed I am, I'll either take time off, which is usually aligned around a holiday. Happens to be that I'm going to Prague at the weekend, so that works quite well. And then I do a combination of that with a D load and a D volume. So today, I've basically pulled all of my sets down one. So I've only got one set on the majority of stuff. And essentially with that one set, I will take my back off from the previous week and just match reps. As long as it's not super high reps, like if it's sub 10, I'll take my back off and just match those reps. And the reason being is you won't be fatigued going into that back off, say your second set, because you've not done the first set. So when you actually do that set, or at least for me, it's probably about 2 to 3 reps in reserve. So that combined with the less volume helps me get nice and recovered across those sessions that I'm actually doing, which makes it easier as well. Like you can just look at your sessions that you did last week. I can see exactly what I got, and I just know that I need to do that. And that's probably my favorite combination of the two. Now, you might prefer a different style, and a different style might be necessary for your certain situation, depending on how fatigued you are. But because I'm kind of like not absolutely battered, I still want to get some good work in, but I want to reduce the volume and keep the intensity there or thereabouts, sort of 2 or 3 reps in reserve. So I guess the final question for this is, how long should you deload / devolume / whatever combination of the two? How long should you do it for? To be honest, I don't think you can set a time to finish the deload or devolume, because you know, you might initially set a week, but if you still feel battered after that week, it's not gonna be a good idea to go straight back up to your normal volume. So I usually like to set 4 to 7 days. And then once you get in that 4 to 7 day realm, keep asking yourself the same questions that you asked at the start. Are you recovered? How's your sleep? How's your appetite? Have those things improved? And if yes, then you can start transitioning into your normal training again, which I'll explain in a sec. Okay, so you finished the deload, you're feeling refreshed, you're ready to get back into training. How do you actually do it? Now, you could, if you were silly, just go back into your normal training like you were doing the week before. But to be honest, that's gonna be too big of a jump. And also, you want to use this opportunity to actually just take a reset of your training and start again in terms of that I guess you could call it a mesocycle, like that next block of training that you're gonna go after. So you can start asking yourself, okay, what was good about the last mesocycle? What was good about the last 8, 12, 14 weeks, whatever it was? What do I wanna keep and what do I wanna change? And then second of all, with your volume, you don't wanna go straight back into doing like, you know, 10, 15 sets per muscle group per week. Pull it right back down. Go all the way back down to sort of, you know, 6 to max 10 sets per muscle group per week. And then for those muscle groups that you really want to prioritize over the coming weeks, you can start increasing volume if that's going to be a good option for you. But definitely do not go back into normal volume, because all that's going to do is a couple of weeks down the line, you're going to be battered again. Because that volume that you're on before is probably slightly over that sort of maximal recoverable volume that you can actually do. So pull it all the way back down. I like to go back down to 6 sets a week and then just gradually taper it back up, depending on how well you're progressing, how you're feeling, etc. So yeah, for me, I'll be going back down to 6 sets a week. It's gonna be probably 3 to 6 sets per muscle group per session. Obviously I only train legs or quads at the minute once a week, so that's gonna be a little bit higher. But for the majority of the muscle groups, 2 to 6 sets, delts, chest, back. I've kind of split back into upper back and lats, but you get the gist. Pull it back down, and then you can start progressing that volume again later down the line. All right, that is the session done in the calf now. I've obviously skimmed over a fair bit, realistically, of deload stuff, but that gives you a good idea. The last thing I want to touch on, which is actually two things. Number one, these deload sessions should not be taking you long. That's taken me 32 minutes. I've got it timed. 32 minutes total. So you really don't want to be spending hours in the gym. Use this as a time to actually just refresh your body, refresh your mind as well, of like, not that the gym's monotonous, but it gives you a bit of a break from it. And then number two is, I've actually not got pre with me. I was going to use it as a prop, but use it as an opportunity to have a deload from other stuff as well. Because at the end of the day, anything that you do, whether it's training or having like caffeine or work or family life, it's all some sort of stressor. And you essentially want to just take away as many of them as possible to recover from everything at once. So when I'm doing a deload, I don't have pre, because what's the point? You're doing 30-minute sessions, the intensity's lower, and the volume's lower. So you don't need that like boosted energy to, like, I don't know, I don't even know what you do it for. So yeah, you don't need it to get through those 30-minute sessions. So definitely take a deload from the pre. Try and have a look into, while you've got a little bit more time as well, the other areas of the life that could be causing stress or could be causing, things that are making the process difficult. So how's your environment? How's the people that you're spending your time around? Is there anything that's actually negatively influencing yourself? And if you can find those things, you can start to fix them while you've got a bit more time away from the gym. Like, you're probably cutting an hour off your sessions, so you might as well use that time productively. Like I am, making a YouTube video. So hopefully you enjoyed. If you have enjoyed this sort of educational style, you'll probably like some of the free stuff I've got below. I'll link the Kickstarter thing. This is like a 7-day free Kickstarter course. I'll also link our lifestyle blueprint, which takes you through everything you need to know to sort of live your life and make progress. And hope you enjoy them. If you have any questions, let me know. See you soon. Ciao.